Let's start off with CBZ Holdings. We saw those results out earlier this week, and we know that they said that they're going to stop on the aggressive lending that they've been embarking on for quite some time. Are you convinced that this company can actually maintain the double-digit growth that we've seen?
Yes, CBZ has been benefiting, I think, from its association with the government for quite some time now. We are well aware that the central bank in the country has not been very functional in terms of playing its lend of last resort. We find that most of government business has been handled by CBZ, and going forward, we think that situation is going to continue. So we expect a lot of high level transactions to continue coming through CBZ. So definitely, at least 10% growth is expected from that counter going forward.
Impairment charges for the company grew around 800%, and we know that this is because the implementation of Basel II has obviously been an issue, and then also looking at the liquidity squeeze overall in Zimbabwe. Can we say that this is going to be a once-off item?
We hope so, but the challenge that the country has been facing is the continued shortage of funds in the money market. We find that borrowers have been continuing to pile loans on their balance sheet, but when it comes to servicing, they've been failing to do that as and when the loans have been maturing. So we find that although this was partly due to Basel II implementation, it was also due to that fact that borrowers factually were failing to service their loans, hence the increase in the number of loans being impaired. Going forward, we have been expecting that the liquidity situation would improve in the country as the country has been exporting its newly found diamonds, but that money has proved to be short of what is required. There's a massive demand for loans opposed to what the country can generate. So we expect the liquidity challenge to continue going forward, though it may recede. So those impairments are definitely going to be with us for quite some time.
So anymore, let's also now move into the mining industry, because this is where we've seen quite a few losses coming to the fore. It has been performing well. We saw Rio Zimbabwe posting an operating loss of $8 million. What is interesting is that we saw diamond outputs coming in very high, more than doubling over the period. Diamond prices are very high right now. Is this going to offset some of the weakness that we've seen in other areas of the business?
For Rios, in particular, the challenge is that diamond production is only coming from an associate. They don't wholly own the Mrua diamonds, where that significant growth came from. It's only an associate which they only take a part, a small part for that matter. But looking at their overall performance, we saw that in terms of the gold production, which is their core business, it went up slightly to 18,500 ounces last year. The gold prices have been firming. I think commodity prices have been firming in international markets. But the challenge with the Rio Zimbabwe has been in extracting that gold out of the ground. They've been facing liquidity challenges, and they had to resort to borrowings. But then again, they were failing to service those loans. So we find that they've been trying to come in the market and try to raise funds to offset that debt. And going forward, we've seen some interest in a Mauritian company in that counter, which we hope will alleviate the challenges going forward.
Okay, if we could also just quickly touch on tobacco selling, give us an indication of your thoughts on the trends there.
Yes, the tobacco crop is one of the major foreign currency earners for this country, and it is one of the commodities which we are hoping to contribute to the alleviation of the liquidity challenges that we are currently experiencing. And to say that we are quite pleased with the performance from that sector. As we are speaking, the selling to date is 22% above what was sold last year. The current crop is standing at 32.9 million kgs, which is about 22% of the total crop that is expected this year. And also, we've seen an improvement in terms of the average price that has been recorded, notably a result of the decline in production from the Americas, both North and Latin American countries.